It's Mundy on Monday, where I am long on thoughts, but short on time. Christmas movies. All of them. Okay, that would be ridiculous, but I did just rewatch Scrooged, and it got me thinking about staples.
We tried crazy glue, but it don't work.
Have you tried staples?
Staples?
Staples.
Here is a take, satire even, of one of the most lasting traditions, staples, in modernish Christmas storytelling. What I mean is, it's a ghost story about getting to the joy of life, rather than the fear of my life or yours. So, diving into Scrooged, it is so over-the-top ridiculous, scary, and fun. Bill Murray's Frank Cross is unleashed, Bobcat Goldthwait himself is unhinged, Karen Allen's Claire is underutilized,
staples,
and luckily for the mice's antlers, they remain unstapled. Oh, and the director, Richard Donner, Superman, The Omen, Goonies, Lethal Weapon, The Toy, not to mention a ton of TV, including The Twilight Zone. The man has a penchant for the realities beyond our five senses, the powers, the mysterious, the, well, ghosts. I think most of the Christmas stories we love to build traditions around and watching are, in essence, ghost stories of joy. What, you don't think Elf is frightening?
You disgust me. How can you live with yourself?
And I don't think this is a coincidence. Wrestling with the real fears we cannot see but want to defeat, with the real hopes we want to see and to be victorious, and the consequences of not taking either seriously enough. A tradition is only as good as that to which it points. So if a movie's tradition only points back self-referentially to itself, we might enjoy it, but it'll never speak deeply. One of the most beloved Christmas movies at a jazzy 25 minutes cuts right through all of that, points away from itself and to how all this began.
And there were in the same country shepherds, and the angel said unto them, fear not.
And upon closer inspection, that's not just a ghost story, that's a Holy Ghost story. Eh? Also, why else are those angels gonna say fear not? Probably because those guys thought they had just seen a ghost or two and were afeared. I know I would be. Even Buddy scares me.
You sit on a throne of lies.
Love you. Anyway, fear not. That's the other side of it. Joy.
I bring you tidings of great joy.
We cannot have an absence of fear without the vacuum being filled with something else of denser, more real quality, and that's what joy is. Shameless plug for my talk on the 2017 movie It. And that's ultimately why at the end of Scrooged, even after I had just welled up over the Tiny Tim moment, it doesn't fully deliver. Aside from the fun, but tacked on, put a little love in your heart, feel-good ending, and the literal ghosts throughout. Wait, did I just describe Ghostbusters 2? The joy feels underdeveloped. I left feeling that fear had actually been used as the motivator rather than just a wake-up call. Yes, thinking we've lost something only to find it or be given a second chance will give us such delight. But ultimately, if we dive that deep into fear, we need to be buoyed by joy. The Christmas stories that wrestle with what the first Christmas inspired can obviously range from the fear of not finding our family to the fear of not being given another chance to simply the fear of not getting our loudest desires we have mistaken for our deepest ones, or even missing or losing the crucial value of wonder. In all of them, I wonder, see, I get the value of it, if part of coming back year after year to our beloved Christmas movies is because we don't just want a Christmas ghost story that's good, we want a particular type of real one, where we get to go to the scariest, darkest of dark void places with the surety that joy has won. And that joy is more real than what we see, more powerful than what we fear, more loving than for what even our imaginations long. Then Buddy isn't just reunited, the relationships are restored. Frank and Claire serve their community as one. Kevin rests in knowing he belongs. Gizmo can bathe without fear. I don't know, as my last post for the year, all my feels are a little turned up, I admit. Yes, commercialism can become fuel for any number of those self-referential traditions.
Hey everybody, these two are looking for a Turbo Man!
Shut up, man!
What's so funny?
But really, I wonder if deep down, it isn't the commercialism that can make us unhappy at Christmas. But maybe it's the giving up too soon on thinking that this ghost story we really want to be true could actually be true. So to bring this review year to a close, if you'd be interested in helping like Claire, check out Hope for New York or hfny.org. That is a great place to start in helping to bring real joy to others. Okay, I've run long, so I gotta go. On behalf of everyone at the Mundy on Monday Studios, I would like to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas, a wonderful New Year, all with unshakable joy. Remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And that's my Mundy. Now back to yours.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening.